YouTube. It's your boy, That Sega Reactions, coming to y'all. Special PayPal request by Karina Williams. Shout out to you. This is an interesting one right here. This is Baz Luhrmann interviews Elvis Presley's childhood friend Sam Bell. Okay, so this is about to be a different one. Like I said before, I tell people all the time, I love when I get different requests. You know what I'm saying? Something that is just out of the realm, out of the blue. I love stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? Something that that I might hate, something that I might love, something that might be shocking. Yeah, I love stuff like that. So, anyway, let's jump into this. Don't forget my Patreon is in the description where you get exclusive access, early content, and special requests. PayPal and Cash App is in the PayPal and Cash App is closed. PayPal and Cash App is closed for new requests. If you would like to still donate, it's completely up to you. You can do whatever you feel like doing. Also, my P.O. box is in the description, so feel free to send me whatever it is you want to send me there. And all right, let's just see what's going on. Like I said before, I love all, and I think you told me to stop at 11 something. So we'll see where we go. Let's see where we head to. You said started at 3:27, but I think it looked, why would I just start in the middle of them talking?
Sit down there and call it past that. We had a swimming pool, swimming hole.
Wait, maybe like.
So this sign that says green in spring, actually this is green and it goes over the gully over there. Got it.
Any mention of Elvis, I'm backing it up.
Your grand folks got a substantial property.
What our property was, had a big pasture down there, called it pasture. We had a swimming pool, swimming hole. It was like a ditch.
A swimming hole, yeah.
And then we had a little fishing place where we fish.
So you'd fish then we had, the gang?
Yeah, and we played our little ball down there too. We went down to the baseball field.
So here is the Spring Hill, Baptist. This is North Green.
Right.
And you know it goes up.
Right.
North Green, and it splits.
Right.
And you know Carver, there's like Carver Elementary.
That's where we went to school right there.
You went to Carver.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But Elvis, he goes to school down here. Would Elvis go?
So they was talking about Elvis before. Wait, let me back it up, because I don't want to miss what I was told to start it at 3. Let's start it here.
Green Street, this is fake Green Street.
Yeah,
that's a fake Green Street.
Okay, well.
This is the old Green Street.
So let's go back to 3. Okay, okay.
Spring Hill Baptist. This is North Green.
Right.
And you know it goes up.
Right.
North Green, and it splits.
Right.
And you know Carver, there's like Carver Elementary.
That's where we went to school right there.
Went to Carver.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But Elvis, he goes to school down here. Would Elvis go every morning from his house to that school on foot?
Mm-hmm. It's not that far. It just seemed like that.
Walk. Yeah. Yeah, because you go across land.
Yeah, right. You look like a long way, but it's not that far.
Okay.
Elvis, honey, you like your Christmas present?
Elvis, you know we can't afford no $55 for no bicycle.
Do they have their thing going on musically?
Yeah, they like
Anyway, when you hear it late, like when you hear them, I mean, just look at the times back then. $55 was the struggle money. Hell, it is still now for a lot of people, but $55. That was, I mean, first of all, that was cheap for a bike, but things
they
were different.
They sent a little group in there.
Yeah.
Couldn't sing. We thought we could, but we and they couldn't sing. They hovered in a little group and sing around, and he would always get the broom. When she bought him a guitar, he can bring it down there.
Why?
So, I don't know.
It's too precious.
Yeah. She let him come out and play, but not with
guitars.
Not with a gun, not with a rifle, not with a guitar. But he'd use his broom. See, we had a tree house there. His daddy built a tree house.
Wow.
It was just a flat.
His daddy did?
Yeah. We'd climb up there, and that's where he kept his broom at all times. So when we get ready to start singing, he'd go over there and go and get his broom.
But listen, what would be the favorite songs of the gang?
We was like church songs. We didn't...
Gospel.
We didn't know anything. We just sang gospel from out of what we heard in church.
Yeah, like
we didn't have any artists. Yeah. He used to like I Fly Away.
How's that one go?
You know, I fly away, oh glory. I like that. Oh, I'll fly.
this is interesting.
That's something, because you know what? Interesting.
Elvis really was a gospel singer at heart. Like, he was a gospel dude.
Everything I read about E.P. in any part of his life, mm-hmm. he's always on about a bit like being a bird, you know, mm-hmm. like learning to sort of fly and mean. And he loved that song,
he
Fly
liked
Away.
He liked that I Fly Away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I fly away.
Did he go that down to that gospel church, or could he go into your church?
Yeah, he could go. We'd go to church. It just matter where you want to go to church. The church was segregated because the people segregated. It wouldn't say a white church or black church.
Right.
If wherever you're closest to, if you wanted to go to that church, you could go.
You could do that.
Yeah. And he enjoyed the one where I was telling you about the sanctified church, where they loved.
Yeah, I don't know who created that narrative of Elvis being racist for you, like. There, he is clearly so far from that, it's ridiculous.
Tambourines and saxophone and drummers going on.
Oh, that band.
Yeah, that's what he liked that.
Yeah.
So does that sound a bit more swing? I'm just trying to...
Yeah, it's swinging.
Because I know, I've seen many interviews where people go, oh, so your first love was... gospel, and he actually said, no, actually, he used to say colored spirituals mm-hmm. was my first love.
Yeah, and that's moving around a lot.
And the movement, right.
Yeah, because he would go up there.
Yeah.
We thought we was too cool for that until he started doing it. We'd go down, we'd just watch.
It's so amazing to see how far that goes back.
Wow. He'd go up in the pulpit. If the band, if the choir and the band up there singing and jumping around, he'd do it too. And he loved that. We just watching.
Elvis knew where it was. Elvis knew what type of party it was. He was always invited to the barbecue. He said, I need to.
Did they find him, like, cute or funny?
That
or
only goes take off.
You know, then. If you showed any inclination about getting religion, yeah. they thought that boy got to religion. That's what they thought. Because anybody in their right mind wouldn't get up there and play like that.
Right.
He wasn't playing. Yeah, so they was happy.
So in a way, maybe there's a feeling that the spirit is within him.
Yeah, we just didn't understand that. We just know he was EP, one of the guys.
That still exists to this day. I've been to church and I've seen it happen.
Hey, man, I said, go get that food. So the guy sent the usher up there, and she told him, come on, it's time to go. We need to go.
This image, man, of him being, like, up there amongst the band with the saxophone.
He wasn't shy.
And this movement thing, like, are you saying he's just, like, moving his hands around, or is he...
Yeah, he's
is
jumping.
Is he popping them, or has he got something else going on?
Like, he do what they do. Yeah. No, he do the same, whatever they do. He liked the guitar. He fantasized his guitar thing. He wouldn't have one, but he'd fantasize. And he'd be jumping, and he'd be singing. He sounded just as well.
He was a good little singer.
He was a good little guy. Yeah.
Well, a lot of people go like...
To us, you know, we say, he ain't singing. Yeah. But to them, he was singing, you know.
Right, got it.
That knew what singing was.
Right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We didn't know.
Let me tell you something that's, for me as an Australian, as an outsider, sometimes you read in the early parts, they go, when
this
they first heard the very first recording, that's the right mama. You know, that's the right mama.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah.
They said that, there are a lot of people said that some of the early guys would go like, oh, that's a black singer, not a white singer.
Okay,
would you have been able to say, no, that was, like, did it sound black sound to you or white sound, or you just didn't care or didn't even?
Sound black to me.
Did it sound black? Yeah,
kind of black to me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you think he picked that up just from being around you guys, like just vocally, that sort of style?
I won't say me, but.
No, but I mean, you're singing gospel.
Yeah.
If you're singing gospel together.
Yeah.
So you can say that. Being in the black church, you know what I'm saying, or, you know, around, like, the, I guess he would call it colored spiritual, you know what I'm saying, we would still call it black church, you know what I'm saying, that influenced him a lot in his early days of music and gospel, you know what I'm saying, like, I think that's tremendously respectful, and also I love the fact that I'm seeing this, because, again, I've seen that last one, and it also just proved it. But I just love seeing it because there's just what they put out there isn't this stuff. you know, about him having a black friend and going to, you know what I'm saying? We heard about him going to the black churches, but to hear his friend talk about it is a different story, and I love that.
See, that's where it came from. I'm really going to have
to... I know you're not, I'm not just being nice, I know you're not boastful, right?
We hit it out. That's all right, Mama.
Seems sensible. I mean, when you're like 7 years old, you're singing, you're moving a certain way. It's right. How would the movement be? You got the gospel.
And then we was doing the foot and doing the pattern.
Yeah. But you know, like say when he gets up in the gospel church, you know, you remember you said.
First of all, I don't know how old this guy is, but he looks great for his age.
It's up in the church and he's like moving like everybody else.
Yeah.
He's using the whole body, or what's he doing?
Yeah. He's using the whole body just like they are doing. They were all back,
forward,
doing that too,
steps,
they were doing all that too.
That.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I mean, it makes sense.
That's where he got it from,
That makes sense.
Just couldn't believe that with him. I didn't think he was paying that
much. That looks so scary in black and white, though, I ain't gonna lie.
Oh, but come on, man. But he was an absorber.
That's something he wanted to do.
But it makes sense. Say, like, for example, it makes sense if you guys go to the barbershop and those dudes are playing guitar and it obviously had a magnetism on him. I mean, he was, as you say.
You sit there and watch him. You watch your fingers, how they do, and they show him. They show him how they do, and you sit there and he's watching me up and down, he's watching. And he plays that broom the same way with his mouth. He makes the same tune with his mouth. He was just a kid in this neighborhood. He wasn't a white kid or black kid. He was a kid. He just one of the kids in this neighborhood.
We had the Cobbs group, the little fat guy. We had all that. And we had the funny talking guy. And when he came out with that, it was such amazing. He must have been looking at us up there. We had the same little group.
You mean like?
We didn't know it was a Cobbs group.
You mean like? Like Fat Albert or something.
Fat Albert,
almost identical.
Wait, hold on. Because this is actually a 24-minute video, but why would we... Why am I doing this from 3 minutes to just 11 if this whole thing is about... to 11 minutes? Yeah, the whole thing is about Elvis. I guess we'll continue the rest, but I was getting so into that. But I do got some other videos to do, but wow. That was amazing. That was completely amazing. Like I said before, I love hearing his backstory. You know what I'm saying? That's the best part about this, because what the narrative is of Elvis is messed up. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, even up until his death, you know, there's I mean, I don't know how he died for real, but it's just like, oh, he died on the toilet. Like, what really, 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 really happened? I mean, I don't know if that's really, really, really what happened, but I'm just saying, that's what they just put out there. And then that's just what they want you to believe. That's what I'm saying. So, yeah, I love this, man. And I think we should continue this maybe on my next set of videos. Thank y'all so much for watching. Comment, like, subscribe, follow me on all my social media platforms. Everything is in the description to next video.